everybody. In a matter of hours, our next guest will be driving across the country to save animals in need. And here to tell us more about it is our pet expert, Larissa Wohl, and Fido Friendly magazine creators, Susan and Greg Sims. Welcome, you guys.
Thank you so much for being here.
Oh, thank you. Thanks for having us.
Yes, I can't wait for them to tell their story. They've been here actually before, Susan and Greg, so thank you guys for coming back. They have this amazing adoption tour, and they are no stranger to the Hallmark family, I should say.
Yeah.
Susan's son, Scott, is actually married to Danica McKellar.
Isn't that crazy?
So we know them very well. There she is on the screen right there with Brandon and you both. And they started Fido Friendly, which is an amazing magazine that helps dog lovers and dog owners who want to travel.
It's such a great idea. I wish I'd had this years ago with my first dog.
Oh, I know.
Trying to figure out the plan of attack for when you're traveling.
That's exactly right.
Pet-friendly hotels and things like that, right?
Yeah, so we're fortunate. We get to take our dogs and sniff out hotels and destinations for purpose of review, and Honey just had her first chance at reviewing a hotel, and she did very well.
Did she enjoy her stay?
She gave it a pause.
So you have been doing this tour, Get Your Licks on Route 66, which I love the name.
It's so cute. Such a great name.
You've been doing it for 9 years. It's so incredible what you do. What can we expect this year?
We are so fortunate. This year, the Petco Foundation came in as our presenting sponsor. So with their help and all the sponsors that go with us, we get to travel from LA to Chicago. We set up a spinning wheel that's about 50 pounds. It's very large. And on the wheel, it's all the sponsors donate product. And when the product, when people come and they stand in line, they will donate money, spin the wheel, and then at the end, we give all the money to the shelter. So we do that across the country. And this weekend is fantastic because we get to kick off in Los Angeles. So we will be at the Petco location in Culver City Friday from 11 to 3. And then Saturday, our spokesperson for the third year is Brandon McMillan. And he is the Emmy Award TV host of CBS's Lucky Dog. So he'll be there Saturday. He'll sign autographs and he'll answer questions for new adoptees or old adoptees.
Will Honey be there signing autographs?
Oh, she might be a daycare.
Okay, just that day.
She might be getting like a spa.
She's a spoiled puppy over here.
So, Larissa, do you think tours like this are helping to change people's perceptions of going with rescue animals?
Yes, 100%. And may I add, they have, in the 9 years, found 9,000 animals.
Wow.
New homes.
Guys, congratulations.
That is so
exciting.
That is huge. It's not just fun. It really is doing so much good.
Thank you.
And yes, we were chatting, actually, and it was really interesting. I said to Susan, now that you've been doing this magazine for almost 20 years, this event for 9, have you seen an evolution in the way that people are reacting to the rescue world? And she said, you know what? Everybody now says, this is Honey, my rescue dog.
I see that all the time here in L.A. It is a bit of a badge of honor.
I think
people are making other people realize what their choice was, and hint, hint, you might want to think about that yourself. I see that everywhere.
And if I may add, the events that you put on, as you saw in those photos, are so fun and engaging and colorful, and there's prizes. And so it takes the pound puppy, the walking through the dreary, sad shelter, and it brings it to a fun location where people might not otherwise see what pound puppies or rescue animals have to offer.
Like this one.
Like, look at this.
And I will say, I'm with you. Like, I'm so proud to say that I have a rescue dog. It really is something to be very proud of. Mm-hmm. And Greg and Suzanne, you guys have a lot going on. Magazine, your tour, you have your sons, grandchildren.
Yes.
Two dogs you had, and then you didn't think maybe you'd have enough room for another animal, but lo and behold, Honey came into your life.
It was meant to be.
We kind of make a point, this is our 9th year, as you guys mentioned, but not to go look at the animals because it's just so difficult to not take them all home.
I can imagine.
And so we were doing pretty well. We got the job from Missouri.
We were doing pretty well.
And then she came out and Susan says, I'm in love. And I just said, this isn't going to work because we can't potty train a dog. We're on the road in and out of hotels. And anyway,
I said, if you love
the dog, I'm sure I'll love her too. So now she's part of the family. And they drove her to Kansas City.
Oh, that was when you first met her.
I don't know what you saw at all. I don't know what you were looking at.
my goodness.
Look at her ears.
You know, there's so many great animals and shelters, and they're doing no fault of their own.
Of course.
You know, they just need loving homes.
A basket for a puppy. So.
Well, good thing that you had a breakdown there.
Yeah,
you
know. It was the thing that really was funny is we just said, there's no way, we have like a month left to go. She's not potty trained. She is now. But anyway, and we had two dogs that were in daycare, and we thought, no. But then it was yes.
Fall in love, and the joy that these animals bring into your lives. I'm so glad you guys found each other.
Thank you guys so much for everything you do.
And best of luck with the tour.
Thank you.
And thank you for all of your work.
Thank you so much.
And next up, we have Chef Mason Partak.
Hi there, my name's Mason Partak, and when we get back, I'm going to show you guys how to make awesome sushi stacks.